Taking you now to Jammu and Kashmir, the Anantnag encounter is on day six right now. And remember, this is while we lost four brave men fighting jihadists in the Kashmir Valley. We're now told that the security forces, special forces, have not only gone deeper into the forest, and they will ensure that all the terrorists will be neutralized, but there is a charred body from the terror hideout of the caves that has been, one charred body has been retrieved by the Indian Armed Forces. DNA sample will likely be taken from the family members of Lashkar-e-Taiba's Uzair Khan. There is a possibility of finding more bodies as anti-terror operation continues. DGP and ADGP will be heading to the encounter site. Reacting to the sacrifices made by our security personnel, JNK Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha said, "Death of our soldiers will be avenged soon and Valley will be terror-free in the coming days." Remember, special forces have been moving to the terror hideout, and it is a... It is not an easy terrain to work in and operate at all. There are forest areas, there are hillocks and cliffs. Operation is still on. There were, at least according to our sources, four terrorists still holed up in the forest of Kokarnag area. And it's believed that they were the ones who led to the killing of the four Indian braves.
जवानों के लोगों के एक कतरे का हिसाब पूरी तरह उस समय दिया जाएगा आतंकी किसी संगठन के उनके सरपरस्तों को बड़ी कीमत चुकानी हर एक बहादुर जवान के पीछे पूरा देश खड़ा जम्मू के हर शहर हर गांव में एक स्वर से आवाम सूरवीरों के हौसला अफजाई के लिए आगे आ रही इसमें कोई संदेह नहीं कि जम्मू कश्मीर पूरी तरह से आतंक से मुक्त हो यहाँ के आवाम की इच्छा है
But this was hard interpretations. They did almost 7 to 8 hours of very steep climb in the jungles. They could contact the place where the terrorists were hiding. So it is just one of the bad luck or the bad days that in the first volley of fire, in the first burst, the command element got hit. Probably they would have been together trying to work out the next strategy or the next phase of the operation after having reached the target area. And the terrorists could see them or probably, you know, locate something and they fired. It is just one of those bad days. That day was not our day.
Hamare fauji ho, hamare police ho, hamari jaan unki khud ki jaan jokhim mein dalkar hamare desh ki sarhad ki raksha karte hain. Aaj valley mein itni badi durbhagyapurna hadsa jo durghatna ghati hai इसका हर एक देशवासी निंदा करेगा मैं भी उसकी निंदा करता हूं
So let's try and get an update on this. My colleague Kamaljeet Sandhu is currently in Kashmir and right on the spot. She's in Srinagar at present. Let's go across to her. Kamaljeet, good morning. You've been tracking for the past 5 to 6 days now the encounter that's on. Give us more details about where does it stand. Of course, we're not giving out operational details, but what are sources in the armed forces telling you, Kamaljeet?
Well, it's day six of Kokarnag operations. And let me tell you, the operational part is more or less over. So yes, there are combing operations which have been taking place. And yesterday there were incessant rainfalls because of which there seems to be a lot of delay. However, the security forces managed to reach the hideout and have recovered one charred body. Now that is going to be sent as far as the DNA samples are concerned. Uzair's family will be called in. An OGW or overground worker will also come in to ensure and identify because some small piece of cloth is also now visible on the body. Meanwhile, we've been speaking to senior police officers who say there would be a larger combing operation done because they've only managed to go to the hideout. And meanwhile, they will spread out today to ensure that if there are any other bodies that are also recovered. Now, there has been one missing soldier who's presumed to be dead. His number has already been factored in, but only after identification, they would really make it an announcement. But meanwhile, it seems that it's been a very arduous and uphill task as far as security forces, especially the Indian Army and Jammu Kashmir Police. Yesterday, there was also a case of accidental fire because obviously there were high tension. There was a bullet which was hit, you know, it was a self-inflicted injury as far as CRPF is concerned. So today, more or less, what we know is the operation does stand over. They will declare it as over. The DG, ADG are expected to head out to the encounter site later in the day. But meanwhile, mostly it is about recovery of more bodies and obviously calling this encounter close to an end.
All right, Kamaljeet Sandhu is tracking all the latest from Kashmir. Kamaljeet, thank you very much for now.